Hi guys, and welcome to this volume shoulder session. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe. Thanks. As you can see here, we just started on the machine shoulder press. As it's a volume workout today, we've just been doing or concentrating on more reps rather than weight. As you can see, I'm just doing, we're incorporating drop sets here. Use as many reps as we can. It's not all about strength on the volume week. As you can see, we go right the way down on the shoulder press and get a really good contraction on the delts. Now, I'm not sure what this machine's called, but it's some sort of shoulder fly delt variation. But it works really, really well on the delts. Brilliant on volume weeks, getting those reps in and making it burn. As you can see, I like to do one arm at a time, similar to my bicep day when I find that I get better contraction doing one at a time rather than both at the same time. Give it a go yourself and let me know what you think. Moving on now to the reverse flies, or the reverse machine flies, however you want to call it. We did this as like a superset between the exercise before. This is really, really good for the back and the rear delts, so I try and incorporate this as much as I can into my workouts, especially the volumes with the more reps. As I said, I use this as a superset. If you notice the way I hold the handles on here, it's like a reverse grip. It really depends on yourself as what feels comfortable, but for me, holding it like that seems to get a better contraction and a better squeeze on the delts and the back. See how you get on yourself and see how you feel with it, basically. Now we're on to a variation of a shoulder press with the cables. This is really, really good. I prefer to do this on the cables on volume week just to get a better contraction on the delts. It seems to work a lot better doing it like this on volume and doing more reps than what it would do with a dumbbell, say. Give it a go. Let me know what you think. If you don't like it, tell me why. Now we're moving on to the bent over flies for the shoulders. This is really good on a volume week. It really gets the shoulders burning. And you don't have to go really heavy with this. Fairly lightweight. I think we was using 25, 30 pound dumbbells here. And that's more than enough. If you can get 12 reps out on that for four sets, you will definitely feel the burn on it. Okay, now we're on to the machine shoulder press. This is a slightly different one from the one we used earlier, so I like to incorporate this one. This is one where the handles both move individually, so you really do get that contraction in the on the shoulders. I definitely recommend using this as well in your workouts. You don't need a lot of weight, as you can see, but you just keep them reps up and you'll definitely feel the burn on it. Okay, now we're on to shrugs. This is an exercise that a lot of people don't tend to do that often. Obviously you can see we're doing fairly lightweight again. We don't need to go heavy because we're doing more reps. But I find it's a really effective exercise for your traps. And it's really good to incorporate it in your shoulder days. So yeah, give it a go. As you can see here, I'm just doing a drop set on it as well. Definitely give that a go, see what you think about that. Start with fairly reasonable weight, then drop it down and take a plate off each side, and then do 12 reps, and then take the plate another plate off a side again and really burn out on it. And give that a go and see what it's like. Let me know what you think. And now we're on to the final exercise of the session. It's like a cable variation with a T-bar. It really focuses on the front delts. I really when I'm doing it, I really contract the shoulder muscles, the delts. A lot of people swing it up, but if you just pull up with your shoulders, just focus the weight on your shoulders, and you'll see some growth in them for definite. Thanks for watching, guys, and as always, please like and subscribe.